are the smallest and lightest of the bunch. So you're going to see them bouncing around a little bit more than they did earlier in the day. When organizers of races such as this start to get into a little bit of wind or waves, this is the first class that we usually have to say, I'm sorry, we can't put you out because you bounce around too much, it's not safe. Luckily this weekend we've been able to put them out every single time. You'll probably notice them bouncing just a little more between the start and finish line and the first corner buoy, but because for some reason there seems to be a pothole out there that they haven't fixed yet. Don't ask me how you get a pothole in water, but you seem to be able to. Okay, the race is underway. It was kind of a motley start. Let's see what happens. We have a spin out in the corner. Liana Richards spun out in the corner. She has to go back and do the corner again. Our other lady driver right now is way up at the end. I don't know what position she's in right now. I thought she was in second. Let's see. Well, there you have it, folks. Unfortunately, my eyes fail me a little bit, and I'm having trouble with reading numbers. However, we are getting a visitor that's going to put a little hold on things here for a few minutes. Matter of fact, behind him is another visitor. So I think it's hot burger and ham dog time, folks, till these ships have gone by, because they create too much wake for our boats to race.
I am with Mike Jr., winner of this Brockville in 1.5 liters, so congratulations.
Thank you very much.
How does it feel?
Oh, I'm shocked now. I just found out that first place boat got a penalty, so I won. It feels good. You know, it's still the boat. We did a lot of work to it. Last race, it wasn't running so well. Brandon went down to the Nationals and won it last weekend. And now, you know, we come here and we work hard, and the boat was running good. And I'm learning a lot, you know, trying to learn how to drive it, and it feels good.
It feels good. So you're getting the new feel of the boat and you feel more comfortable. How do you feel about Valleyfield in 2 weeks now?
You know, everyone loves Valleyfield. Everyone wants to win Valleyfield. You know, there's a lot of competition. I mean, there'd be nothing better than to win in Valleyfield. That's my dream since I've been a little boy watching boat race. So if I could win anywhere, it'd be there.
Thank you and congratulations.
Thank you so much.